This edition of the Fun Astrology Podcast is brought to you by Levels of Energy audiobook, written by Frederick Dodson and narrated by me. Learn how the entire universe is structured on energy and how, when we operate from low levels of energy, we naturally attract negative things into our life. But when we shift to operating from higher levels of energy, we are protected from negative things and actually start drawing beautiful things into our life. Levels of Energy audiobook is available on audible.com and iTunes. It is Tuesday, April the 6th. Thomas Miller on the Fun Astrology Podcast. Welcome aboard. Glad you are here. Let's take a look at the sky, and then we're going to jump into a listener question about what you just heard, actually, the Levels of Energy audiobook, as promised yesterday. So we don't have, again, you're going to hear this a lot this week, we don't have much going on. The moon is still in Aquarius. Don't tell me what to do. Tomorrow it slides into Pisces. And it's actually tomorrow afternoon, so we've got today and a good chunk of tomorrow with the moon in Aquarius. Tomorrow, actually, most of the day will be in void, of course, because it begins at 6:04 a.m. Let's talk about the keywords today. They are really favorable, and this is part of that change that we are starting to slowly morph into. But listen to some of these top, more energetic, vibrant keywords for today across the day parts. Success, joy, sociability, don't we wish, encounter, friendship, success, love. Don't you love that list? There are a few from the past that we've been talking about, but they're much lower intensity. So actually, that's pretty much how the week carries through. Now, as you know, we have some time on these slower days for listener questions, and I had a great one from Patrick, who lives in the Canadian Rockies, who said that he found the podcasts through the Levels of Energy audiobook and had a great question about that related to astrology. Patrick from Canada.
Have you ever thought about incorporating that scale into your astrology podcast? Because obviously when there is some energy in your life, in order to progress through that, there are other energies that are sort of the neighbors to that energy, and rising out of something to maintain a spiritual upward trajectory can be a little hard sometimes, but that's one thing that both astrology and the scale seem to have in common. So just wanted to throw that out there and hear your thoughts. I thought it would make for an interesting show.
And one that I wouldn't have thought of to tie together, actually. Isn't that funny how that works? But thank you, Patrick, for that great question. You can leave your question on the funastrology.com website. Right at the top, there's an orange button. You click it and just record your message like he did. Would love to have those, especially during these slow times. They come in handy. So thank you very much. Okay, let's talk about the levels of energy concept here just briefly. So Fred Dodson wrote this book, I think, back in 2010. I narrated it in 2013. It basically takes all of the emotions and a lot of the energies that we see represented in the astrological chart and puts them on a scale from low to high, numerically from zero in our Earth experience to, let's say, about 600. And then higher non-Earth realm energies go up to 1,000 and beyond. So a lot of humanity operates in, say, the 200s. What you would expect to be low: anger, pride, narcissism, guilt, anxiety, depression, etc. Those are sub 200, below 200. Average 200, above average 300, and low higher realm 400, high realm 500 and 600. And in the higher realms, you find obviously love and joy and peace and gratitude and creativity and the things that cause our heart to jump and leap. And the idea is, and like Patrick is saying, sometimes it's hard to live those higher energies. And that is the tension of life on planet Earth school. And that is what is represented in the chart. And that's why when we're talking about these signs, like yesterday we were talking about all this energy stacked in Aries, all right, there's a positive side to Aries, Mars, rulership. Yes, the warrior has a positive side. The positive side is, if there wasn't Mars in the chart, you wouldn't put your foot on the floor in the morning and get out of bed. because the next sign over, Taurus, would have you cocoon back up, snuggle your partner, pull the covers up, and we'll see you for dinner. Aries is like that story they say about the lion and the antelope on the tundra, right? You know, the sun comes up over the tundra and a lion wakes up and realizes that if it doesn't eat, it will starve. And in order to eat, it has to go out and hunt. And the gazelle wakes up and realizes that it is the prey. And if it doesn't run and hide, it will get eaten. So the point of the story is, whether you're a lion or a gazelle, the sun is up and you better be running. Well, that's Aries. And on the scale of energy, a positive Aries is going to be running into creativity and joy. And how can I serve others? And how can I fulfill my own desires and my own heart and intersect that with serving others? The opposite side of that is what we've been seeing in the news lately, where that same energy could be channeled so positively, gets channeled negatively. And in the most recent cases, people are dying. Anger, psychosis, rage, all bundled within the same astrological symbol. So do you see when we talk about these things and people want to ascribe these energy reflectors called the planets and the signs and the houses, and they want to describe it in some kind of cookie cutter way? Oh, that's Saturn, that's bad. That's Mars, that's bad. Ah, Venus, that's love, that's good. Jupiter, oh, what a lucky day. Okay, you can talk about one side of the coin, but you better flip it over if you want to be comprehensive. And nobody would be so foolish as to, for a second, believe that anything about this experience on Earth only has one side, right? So that's what the levels of energy explains, and that's what the astrological chart explains. And that's why we have to read it as a whole, comprehensively. We have to look at the shadow, and we have to look at the good as well. All right? That's how they integrate. Patrick, thank you. You're a rock star. I appreciate it. Go to funastrology.com and leave me a message. I'd love to have a couple more for the rest of this week. Have a great Tuesday. We'll see you tomorrow for Hump Day. Bye-bye.